take the finite risk of trusting like a child. I believe, help thou my unbelief. I walk into the unknown, trusting all the while. I long so much to feel the warmth that others seem to know. But should I never feel the thing, I claim him even so. I believe, help thou my unbelief. I walk into the unknown, trusting all the while. I walk into the unknown, trusting.
Good morning, Holy Spirit, for such a wonderful day given, for our celebration. Thank you, Lord, that you are the true shepherd and you know your sheep, and we are one of them. Help us and open our spiritual eyes so that we may see what you are doing in our life. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Friends, although spiritual blindness always hides in people's belief system, most of the time, truth that is supposed to remove such blindness becomes or can be a bitter pill for people to swallow. In John chapter 10, verse 15 to 42, why do you think the Jews were able to contend against the fact that Jesus of Nazareth was the Christ? Christ means the anointed one. In the Old Testament times, anointing signified being set apart for service, particularly as a king. Especially 1 Samuel chapter 16 verses 1 and 13. Or as priest, Exodus 40, 13 to 15. It was not therefore easy to answer the Jews as to whether Jesus was the Christ because of the different ideas of the Messiah that was common. To the Jews, the Messiah was supposed to be a political deliverer, which Jesus was not. The people of our generation do not need to ask whether Jesus was the Christ. This is clear in the scriptures. The problem with the Jews was unbelief. They saw the miracles, but they did not understand the significance. John 20, 30 to 31. Is the unbelief in your heart which could be blocking your blessings? I pray that you ask the Lord to help you overcome it. Do you hear Christ's voice? Does he know you? And to follow you all the days of your life. While the Jews saw Jesus as a mere man, and so his claim that he was the Son of God was to them a total blasphemy and was the reason they tried to stone him. Their biased and distorted ideas, that preconceived ideas, have blocked their minds against the truth. Unlike these Jews, many people beyond the Jordan even believed, as verse 42 tells us. And even they checked and confirmed that all that John said about Jesus was true. Indeed, Jesus had been set apart by the Father, as verse 36 tells us. And the miracles he performed were part of the evidence of his divinity. Despite counterfeit genuine miracles, can still be a way to lead people to faith in Jesus Christ. As we witness to other people about the saving grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, let us remember that we are bound to meet opposition. However, we can rely on the scriptures as Jesus did, especially in verse 35, and on his presence and concern for us. Rejoice in Christ and let the world know that Jesus is indeed Christ, the Messiah. Jesus did what his Father did. Verse 37 attests to this. There is an adage that says, like father, like son. Can people see Jesus in you? Jesus continues the work of soul winning. As verse 41 to 42 encourages us to do. Beloved of the Lord, remain focused on God's assignment for your life. We are on the Lord's side. We are on the Savior's side. Yes, we are dying, O Lord. Dear Lord, please give us a heart that is open to your word and responds to the truth it reveals. Thank you for listening. God bless you. Till we meet again. Bye-bye.
I believe, help thou my unbelief. I take the finite risk of trusting like a child. I believe, help thou my unbelief. I walk into the unknown, trusting all the while. I long so much to feel the warmth that others seem to know, but should I never feel a thing, claim him. even so, I believe. Help thou my unbelief. I walk into the unknown, trusting, although into the unknown, trusting.